Good morning, everyone. So today we will discuss about the introduction to human body, anatomy and physiology. So before going to explain about what is anatomy and what is physiology and introduction to human body, we must know understand about why we are studying about these things. What is the scope of studying these introduction to human body, anatomy and physiology, and why it is the objective and what is the learning outcome of these topics. Okay. So the first thing is the scope. This subject is designed to impart the fundamental knowledge on the structure and function of the various system of the human body. So by studying this topic, you can explain very well about the structure and function of the different system of the human body. It also helps in understanding the both homeostatic mechanism. That means how the body will maintain their homeostasis. You can understand easily. The subject provides the basic knowledge required to understand the various disciplines of pharmacy. Need of these disciplines. Upon completion of this topic, this subject course, you are able to understand, you are able to explain the gross morphology, the structure and function of the various organs of the human body. We know human body will contains the different organs. You can explain about their anatomy, physiology. You can describe the how the homeostasis will maintain and their imbalance will be there. You can identify the different tissue and organs present in the body. You can perform the various experiments related to the special senses and the nervous system. And you can appreciate the coordinated working pattern of the different organ of each system, because we know the organs will coordinate with each other. Then the homeostasis can be maintained. After studying this chapter, the learning outcome will be like you can distinguish between the anatomy and physiology. You can identify the several branches of each, that means anatomy and physiology. You can describe the structure of the body, the simplest as well as the complex structure. You can easily explain. You can identify the functional characterization of human life. You can identify the four requirements of the human survival. Then in medical terms, there is a anatomical terminology is used for the specific part, for the specific region of the body. So you can understand these anatomical terminology and you can identify the key body structure, body region and direction in the bodies. You compare and contrast at least four medical imaging techniques in the terms of their function and the uses of the medicine. So you can easily explain about these imaging technologies. Now come to the point, come to the core topic, anatomy. Human anatomy is the scientific study of the body structure. In a very simple words, in a very easy words, you can simply say that the study of body structure, that will be the anatomy. The study of body structure. Some of these structures are very small and can only be observed and analyzed with the assistant of microscope. Other larger structures can readily be seen, manipulated, measured and weighed. This anatomy words comes from a Greek root that means to cut apart. So anatomy word is derived from the Greek word that means to cut apart. You can also say it in a modern term is the dissection. Okay, when you cut any organs, you when you dissect the any organs, you can see inside them. Similarly, anatomy can be defined the study of body structure, how it composed, how it structured. Okay, for example, if you are study the heart, how heart is structured. Okay, sorry. How many layer they have? How many chamber they have? You all can be explained, and you can explain only when you dissect the organs. When you can see inside the heart, then you can explain the heart having the four chamber, the heart having the this type of the wall, the heart having the this type of the artery. These all can be explained only in those cases when you dissect that particular organ. So that is the anatomy, to cut apart. Now there's two things. Some structure are the large enough so you can see by your naked eye. Okay, you can see easily without the adding of any magnification or microscope. But some structure are a very tiny, very small. You cannot see by your bare eye. You cannot see by your naked eye. You must need the microscope. Okay. So these are the called the microanatomy. Microstructure is there. And the large structure who can really be measured roughly, really be can be seen, really can be weighed. You can see them, you can weight them, you can measure them. So that will be known as the gross structure, your gross morphology. Okay. Now the two branches of the science, anatomy and physiology, they provide the foundation for understanding the body's part and function. If you want to understand the body's part, body function, you must know about the anatomy and physiology. Anatomy, ana means up, tomy means process of cutting. To cut apart, we already discussed it. So you can define the anatomy is the science of body structures and the relationship among them. Science of body structure and their relationship among them. It was first studied by the dissection. Dissection, this means apart, sections means act of cutting. The careful in cutting apart a body structure to study their relationship. So when we cut the structure, then we can understand about their particular parts. For example, if you cut a kidney, then you are able to see that inside the kidney there is a cortex, there is a medulla, there is a pelvis, there is a calluses, major calluses, minor calluses, there is a pyramids in the medulla, papillae is there inside, nephron is there inside. Is it only possible when you dissect the kidney? And what is the relationship between them? How cortex and medulla are correlate? How cortex and medulla are helping? How cortex and medulla are, that means having any relation? So these things are only possible when you cut the particular organ. So that is the anatomy. So anatomy is the just study of body structure, that anatomy. If you are study the body structure, that means you are talking about the anatomy. So if you want to define the anatomy, you can define it. Anatomy is the science of body structure and the relationship among them. Science of body structure and what is their relationship between them, among them. So that is the anatomy. Today, a variety of the imaging techniques also contribute to the advancement of anatomical knowledge. In current scenario, in current work, you will see there is a different imaging technologies developed that will help to see the anatomical structure of the particular organ. Whereas anatomy deals with the structure of the body, physiology is talking about the function of the body. जहाँ पे हम एनाटॉमी की बात कर रहे हैं, जो कि बॉडी के स्ट्रक्चर को रिलेट कर रहा है, physiology is only talk about the science of body function. Now, how it work? For example, if we cut the heart, then we can see the inside. That is anatomy. But how heart work? Okay. That is called the physiology of the heart. How the kidney will work? That is the physiology of the kidney. So where the anatomy is talking about this structure of the body, physiology, that is physio means nature, logy means study. So study of their nature, how it work, is the science of body function. How the body part work, that will be called the physiology. Now these are the several common medical imaging procedures and medical imaging technique. Like first one is the radiography. You know very well about the radiography. Radiography, it is necessary to use a substance that we call the contrast medium to make hollow of fluid fields structure visible in radiograph. if you talk about the procedure, how it can perform. So a single pairs of X-ray passes through the body, producing an image of interior structure on X-ray sensitive films. The resulting two-dimensional images in the radiography, commonly called X-ray. You all heard about the X-ray. Maybe in the life, once a time, you encountered this condition, X-ray. So X-ray is nothing, it's just a radiography techniques. Okay? Where the X-rays, the beam, the light is passes through the inferior structure of the body parts on X-ray sensitive film. So the radiographs are relatively inexpensive, quick and simple to be performed, and usually provide the sufficient information for diagnosis. So X-ray do not easily pass through the dense structure, so bones appears white. Hollow structures such as the lungs appears black. Structure of intermediate density such as skin, fat and muscles appear as a varying shades of gray. At low doses, the X-ray are useful for examining the soft tissue such as the breast and for determining the bone density. So it is the radiographic property, X-ray. These are the several imaging techniques. So X-ray are used to image the blood vessels, angiography is there. In the urinary system, intravenous urography will be there. And in the GIT tract, in our digestive system, the barium contrast X-ray will be used. So these are the techniques. You have also heard the name that called the MRI. MRI, magnetic resonance imaging. Magnetic resonance imaging. So how it will perform, how the magnetic resonance imaging will work. So the body is exposed to a high energy magnetic field. Body will be exposed to a high energy magnetic field, which causes the protons, the small positive particles within the atom, such as the hydrogen in body fluids. This causes a proton in body fluids and tissue to arrange themselves in a relation to the field. Then a pulse of radio waves reads these in ion patterns and color-coded images is assembled on a video monitor. The result is a two or three dimensional blueprint of cellular chemistry. So that is called the magnetic resonance imaging, MRI. You have also heard the name CT scan, that we call computed tomography. How CT scan will perform? Computerized assisted radiography, in which an X-ray beams tracked an arc at multiple angle around a section of the body. It is a computerized radiography. The resulting transverse section of the body called CT scan. It's shown as on the video monitor, so you can see there. Ultrasound scanning is there. You all heard the very familiar ultrasound scanning. How it performs? The high frequency sound waves produced by a handled wand reflect off the body tissue and are detected by the same instrument. The image which may be still or moving is called the sonograph and is shown on a video monitor. Sometimes it is a safe, non-invasive, no painful, painless, no such any type of the injury, and users no dies. Most commonly used to visualize the fetus during the pregnancy. So ultrasound will be used to visualize the fetus during the pregnancy, also used to observe the size, location and the action of the organs and the blood flow through the blood vessels. Doppler ultrasound is also there. Another is called the positron emission tomography. It is a new for you. You heard the ultrasound, you heard the CT scan, you heard the magnetic resonance imaging technique, MRI, you heard the radiography, X-ray, but positron emission tomography, it is a PET techniques. It is a new for you. In this case, a substance that emit the positron, that means positively charged particle, a substance that emits the positively charged particle is injected into the body. Okay, where it is taken up by the tissue, when it will be injected into the body, it will taken up by the tissue, and this collection of positron with negatively charged electron in the body tissue produce the gamma rays. So that are detected by the gamma cameras positioned around that particular subject, and a computer receives the signals from the gamma cameras and contrast a PET scan images will be there. So display in color on a video monitor, the PET scan shows where the injected substance is being used in the body. In the PET scan image shown here in the below, you can see the PET scan images. The black and blue color indicate the minimal activity. The red, orange, yellow and white color indicate the area of increasing the greater activity. So it is used to study the physiology of the body structure, such as metabolism in the occurred in the body, brain, heart, so you can see the these things, organs. Radionucleoid scanning, the radionucleoid scanning, it will also new for you. A radionucleoid, a radioactive substance, is introduced intravenously into the body. So by IV, a radioactive substance is introduced in your body, that is the radionuclide, and carried by the blood to the tissue to be imaged. For those tissue which we want to take a image, we must have inject this radioactive substance into the artery, into the intravenous circulation. It will goes to the particular tissue. Gamma rays emitted by the radionucleotides are detected by a gamma camera outside the subject and fed into the computer, so we can monitor them, we can see it. Common medical imaging procedure, endoscopy is there. Endoscopy is widely known. The visual examination of inside of the body organs or cavity using a light instrument with a lens called an endoscope. The image is viewed through an eyepiece on the endoscope or projected onto a monitor. So there is a light instrument, lightweight instrument, which contains one lens on the their top, that is the endoscope, and the image can be viewed through that eyepiece on the opposite side. Example of endoscopy like include the colonoscopy. If you want to see the structure inside the colon, the colonoscopy will be there, laparoscopy will be there, arthroscopy will be there. Colonoscopy is used to examine the interior of the colon, part of the intestine. Laparoscopy is used to examine the organ with the abdominopelvic cavity. And arthroscopy is used to examine the inferior of a joints, usually the knee. So these are the different endoscopy. When a body is dissected, the structure are cut apart in order to observe their physical attributes and their relationship to one another. We already discussed. Dissection is still used in the medical schools, anatomy courses, and in pathology lab. In order to observe the structure in living people, however, a number of imaging techniques have been developed. You can understand earlier, okay, the decades earlier, there is no such type of the imaging techniques at that time. Okay, for example, in the today scenario, in the today's world, we have lots of the imaging technique, like we have the CT scan, we have MRI, ultrasound, X-ray, PET technique, positron emission tomography is there, endoscopy is there, lots of the imaging technique. So without cutting the organs, we can see inside the organ. Okay, if you want to see inside the intestine structure, if you want to see the how the duodenal ulcer is there, yeah, how many problems occurring in the duodenum, yeah, intestines, if you want to just see the structure of the intestines, is it easy? You can do the endoscopy. if you want to see the structure of the brain, you can perform the CT scan. But before these imaging techniques, there are no such things that can tell us, that can give us which type of the structure are this particular organ. So at that time, dissection is the only things that can be used. So in the medical schools, in the anatomy courses, in the pathology labs, dissection is the only things by which we can study the structure of particular organs. Now in the current world, when these techniques will be developed, dissection is less, because without the dissection, we can see, we can perform such type of the observation. So these techniques allow a clinicians to visualize the structure inside the living body, such as the cancerous tumor or a fractured bone. So if you want to see the cancer present inside the particular organ or the fractured bone, so we can use these imaging techniques, and you can see the structure inside the body, where the bone is going to break, is where the tumor is going to form. So there is no need up to dissection. Anatomy, as I told you, this is the study of body structure and the relationship among them. There is a several subdivision of the anatomy, like surface anatomy, gross anatomy, systemic anatomy, regional anatomy, radiographic anatomy, developmental anatomy, embryology, cytology, pathological anatomy. So these all are the different condition, different branches, and different subdivision of the anatomy. Superficial study, surface anatomy, those things that we can see the easily by the eye, gross anatomy. If you're talking about the systemic thing, systemic anatomy, regional anatomy. If you're talking about the embryo anatomy, so these are the subdivision. Gross anatomy is the study of larger structure of the body without the assistant of microscope or magnification. We can see the organs. So that is called the gross anatomy. Macro means large, micro means small. You know about it. So the gross anatomy is also referred as a macroscopic anatomy. So if you're going to study the large particles, large organs, that will be the macro anatomy. In contrast, micro, that will consider as small, is the study of a structure that can be observed only with the microscope or any other magnification devices, like cytology. The study of cell and the histology, the tissue, we cannot see the by naked eye. So we need the assistant, we need the help of microscope or magnification. Anatomists take the two general approaches to the study of the body's structure, regional and systemic. Okay, so the anatomist is the those that is the expert in the anatomy. So they have two approaches for the study of body structure. One is the regional approaches, second is the systemic approaches. Regional anatomy is the study of the interrelationship of all of the structure in a specific body region. Regional anatomy means we are talking about the anatomy, study of the structure. Region means a particular area. So in a particular area, in a specific area, the study of structure is called the regional anatomy. So it is a study of the interrelationship of all the structure that is specified in a particular body region, like the abdomen. Abdomen is a region. Abdomen is not an organ. Abdomen is a region. And inside the abdomen, there are several organs, like the stomach is there, liver is there, pancreas is there, present inside the abdomen. So when we are going to study the regional anatomy, we have to figure like this. studying the regional anatomy help us to appropriate the interrelationship of the body structure, such as the how muscle, nerve, blood vessels, and other structure work together to serve as a particular body region. In contrast, the systemic anatomy is the study of the structure that make up a discrete body system. Systemic anatomy will talk about a complete system of anatomy. That means a group of structure that work together to perform a unique body function. Group of structure that work together to perform a unique body function. For example, respiratory system. In respiratory system, there is several organs involved in the respiratory system, like nose is there, pharynx is there, larynx is there, trachea is there, bronchial tubes is there, then alveoli, then lungs is there. In gastrointestinal tract, in GIT, you can say the digestive system. It is a system, digestive system. So in the digestive system, we have to study about the mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine. So these are the difference between the regional anatomy and systemic anatomy. In the regional anatomy, we will discuss about the structure of organs in a particular region and the relationship among them. While the systemic anatomy, you are talking about the group of the structure that perform a unique function. Okay. Now, after the anatomy, you will see the physiology is there. We already discussed, I already told you, where the anatomy is talking about the body structure, physiology will talk about the body function, organ function. So physiology is the study of the scientific study of the chemistry and physics of the structure of the body and the ways in they work together to support the function of life. And we know by maintaining the physiology of the organ, we can maintain the homeostasis. There are several subdivisions in physiology also, like the cell physiology, the function of cell, neurophysiology, function of neurons, nerve cells, endocrinology, that means function of hormones, study of hormones, cardiovascular physiology, function of the heart and blood vessels, immunophysiology, respiratory physiology, renal physiology, exercise, yeah, you can, it's a excretory, so be excretory physiology, like the muscular physiology, pathophysiology, system physiology, reproductive physiology. So these are all the subdivision of the physiology. Like anatomist, physiologist typically specialize in a particular branch of physiology, for example, neurophysiology. Like anatomist, physiologically is also specific for their branch. Like neurophysiology is there. So the neurophysiology is the only the study of the brain and spinal cord, that means nerves, nerve cells. And how they work together to perform the function as a complex and diverse as a vision, a movement, thinking. So physiologists may work from the organ level to the molecular level. For example, the thin flap of your eyelid can snap down to clear away dust particles and almost instantaneously slide back up to allow you to see the gain at the microscopic level. The arrangement of the function of these nerves and muscles that are serve as the eyelid allow for it to quick action and retreat. Neurophysiology, how the nerve cell will work. When someone throwing a ball on your face, your eyes will closed, your hand will raised, or when the dust particles blown on your face, your eye will be closed for a moment, and then wind goes off, your eyes will open. So how these nerves are going to work, in which manner, how they perform their function, it all can be easily explained through the neurophysiology. An introduction to human body, the first thing anatomy we all discussed is science of structure, relationship, revealed by the dissection, cutting apart, imaging techniques is there. In physiology, we study the science of body function, Normal adult physiology is studied in this class, and some genetic variation occurs. Now, selected subspecialties of the anatomy and physiology. So there is a different subspecialties of the anatomy. What does it mean? What is the study of? And it is tabulated in a table. So first one is the embryology. Embryology, that means you can say the first 8 weeks of the development of following fertilization of an egg. In human, after the fertilization, the development of egg, the first 8 weeks. Okay, 4 weeks a month, 8 weeks, 2 months. So 2 months development of egg. The study of that particular things is called the embryology, formation of the embryos. Then developmental biology, the complete developmental of an individual from fertilization of an egg to the teeth, developmental biology. So from the fertilization, from the development of an embryo to the develop to their death, all the range is the developmental biology. Is the developmental biology, cell biology, cell structure and function, histology. Histos means tissue, and logy means study. So it's a tissue study and function. Histology, the microscopic structure of the tissue. Surface anatomy. Surface marking of the body to understand the internal anatomy through the visualization and palpation. By the gentle touch, surface anatomy, gross anatomy, structure that can be examined without the using of any help, without the using of microscope, gross anatomy, systemic anatomy, structure of the specific system of the body such as the nerves or respiratory system, nervous system, respiratory system, digestive system, muscular system, any system. Regional anatomy, a specific region of the body such as the head or chest. Just like I give example that abdomen. Similarly, you can see second example is the head. Head is a region. In the head, there is a brain, and brain having the several parts. You can study in the chest. Chest is the region, chest is the area where ribcage is there. And in the ribcage, you can see intercostal muscle is there. Inside them, there is a lungs is there. Okay. Several blood vessels is there. So you can study those things. Radiographic anatomy. Body structure that can be visualized with X-ray imaging. So that can be radiographic anatomy. Pathological anatomy. Structural changes associated with disease, pathological anatomy, from goose to microscopic. So pathology means we are going to study about the structural changes due to the any disease or disorder. It is pathological anatomy. Neurophysiology. Neuro means nerve cell, physiology means function. So the function of the nerve cell. Endocrinology. Endo means within, crine means secretion, within the secretion. So hormone and how they can control the body function. The function of the hormone is there. Cardiovascular physiology. Cardio means heart and vascular means blood vessels. So function of the heart and blood vessels. Immunology. How the body defends itself against the disease causing agent. That means our immunity. So study of the our immunity, study of the, our antibodies. That will be immunology. Respiratory physiology. How the air passes and lungs can perform their function. That will be respiratory physiology. Renal physiology. Function of the kidney. Renal means kidney. So how the kidney will perform their function. Exercise physiology. Changes in the cell and organ function as a result of muscular activity. when we change, when we perform some muscular activity, when we perform some exercise, how the cells and the other organs will change their function. Pathophysiology. Function changes associated with the disease and aging. With the disease, with the age, the function of the particular organ will be changed. So that will be the pathophysiology. Okay, so two things you have to remember: pathology and pathophysiology. Pathology is just a study of the particular disease, while pathophysiology is the function of the changes in the cells due to the disease. Now there is a quiz, and the first question is, which major organ lies deep to the right hypochondriac region? Which major organ lies deep to the right hypochondriac region? Stomach is there, spleen is there, liver or duodenum? Hypochondriac region. So answer C is correct. Liver is there. Next question, which plane of the body divides it into the dorsal and ventral region? Dorsal and ventral. If you see, there's a different planes, like transverse planes, axial planes, coronal planes, sagittal plane. Which planes can divide the body into the dorsal and ventral? So coronal. Answer C will be correct. Question number third. The directional term superior in anatomy means which of the following? Superior, cephalic, ventral, caudal, and dorsal. So which one is superior? Superior means, you know, what is the meaning of the superior? Superior means upper side, inferior means lower side. So cephalic, answer A is correct. Next question, which of the stated relationship is correct? Which of the stated relationship is correct? A, the heart is inferior to the clavicle. Which statement is correct? The heart is inferior to the clavicle. Heart kya clavicle se inferior hai? Inferior means below. Clavicle. Clavicle samajhte hain? Clavicle, there is the name of the bone, clavicle bones. You can also say collar bones, or you can say the beauty bone, clavicle bone. So is heart is inferior to the clavicle? Yes, it is, yes. But let us see the another option. Second question. The shoulder is distal to the carpals. Is our shoulder is distal to the carpals? No. The phalanges are proximal to the metacarpals? No. The eye is medial to the eyebrows? No. So answer A is correct. What is the study? Next question will be, what is the study of how body part function called? How body part function called? Is the histology. Histology is the study of tissue. So no, it is not a function. Homeostasis is there. Homeostasis, that means our all internal involvement, body's internal involvement at normal state. So no, it's not correct. Metabolism is there. No, metabolism is also incorrect, because metabolism is the chemical conversion. Then physiology is there. Physiology is the function, study of the function of the organ. Yes, so answer B is correct. Question number next. Which one of the following statement is correct? Now there's a below, there's a listed four statement is there. Now which statement is correct? First, the diaphragm separate the brain and spinal cord. The diaphragm means separate the brain and spinal cord. Brain and spinal cord, both of the part of the nervous system, while diaphragm is the parts of the diaphragm is just below the heart.
hypochondria generated our abdominal parts, and the chest part is going to divide with the help of the diaphragm. So no, it is not correct. Next question. The ventral cavity contains the male and female reproductive system. The ventral cavity contains male and female reproductive system. No, it is also incorrect. The abdominopelvic cavity contains the spinal cord. Spinal cord is a part of the nervous system. Brain and spinal cord. No. Incorrect. The dorsal cavity contains the brain and spinal cords. Yes. The dorsal cavity contains the brain and spinal cords. Next question. To what does the term hypochondriac refer? Hypochondriac. The region of abdomen that will inferior to the ribs. The region of abdomen that inferior to the ribs. Jo ribs ke niche hai, abdomen ke parts. Hypochondriac region. That is referred as a chondria. So answer B is correct. But what answer A said? A condition of having the too few chondria? No. A person who often complains of an ailment? No. Having insufficient cartilage in the knee? No, not related. So answer B is correct. Next question. What are the tendons and ligament composed of? Tendons and ligament are composed of. Now, before explaining the tendons ligament, you should know what is the tendons and what is the ligament. When the muscles are connected to the bone, that is connected through the tendons. And ligament that will connect the bone to bone. But what are the tendons and ligament composed of? Kis cheez ke bane hain ye? Epithelial tissue, muscular tissue, connective tissue. Yes, connective tissue. But which type of the connective tissue? It's a dense connective tissue. So answer A is correct. Tendons and ligament are composed of dense connective tissue. Which of the following is not epithelial tissue? Ab isme se kaun sa aisa hai jo epithelial tissue nahi hai? Sorry. Epidermis. Glandular tissue. The internal lining of the blood vessels. No, these all are the epithelial. So dermis. Dermis is there. Dermis is not epithelial tissue. So answer D is correct. Now last question. What are lysosomes, centrosomes and ribosomes example of? Is it a stem cell? No. Lysosome, centrosome, ribosome, these all are the cell organelles. B. Organelles within the cell? Yes, correct. C. Sensory receptor in the dermis? No. Exocrine glands? No. So D is correct. Answer B is correct. So today in class, we studied about the basic introduction of the anatomy and physiology. How can we define anatomy? How can we define physiology? That means anatomy is the study of body structure, while physiology is the study of body function. There is a different subdivision of anatomy, different subdivision of physiology is there. And after that, there is a different susceptible words that can be used in the medical terms. Okay, we also discuss a little bit introductory part about the introduction to human body. Which type of the studies is called this? Which type of studies is called that? Like neurology is there, okay? Endocrinology is there, renology is there. So these are the different parts. Now you all have to refer these standard reference book. The first is the Principle of Anatomy and Physiology, Tortora, Gerard J. Tortora. It is a well-known, renowned author and an excellent book of our anatomy and physiology. So you can read the all the anatomical terms, all the physiological terms and different concept about the anatomy and physiology in the Tortora. You can also prefer the Bill and Melinda. You can also prefer the robins have got drawn, pathological basis of the disease. So in this you can see the different pathological and the pathophysiology of the disease developed. Okay, so I already explained what is the difference between the pathology and pathophysiology. Except that you can also prefer the some web link for your study. And then next class we will start again new topic. Till then, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.